Okay, I want to talk to all of you about procrastination. I'm using this book, The Procrastination Equation, by Piers Steele. It's one of the few self-help books that I recommend. According to Dr. Steele, 95% of us procrastinate. I have a feeling that he's being very optimistic there, that probably 100% of us procrastinate occasionally. Now, he does tell us that there are several reasons we procrastinate. We tend to put off tasks that are unpleasant. We tend to put off tasks that we think we can do at any time. Those are usually those of you who say you work best under pressure, which Dr. Steele says is an entire fantasy. And we tend to put off tasks that, we have better things to do with our life. And so we go do the better things instead of those tasks. And it says that eventually we get around to doing the task as we approach deadlines. We start to get worried. We get more and more worried. I wish you could see in here, there's this nice little chart that shows the worry curve. And we don't tend to do tasks that are unpleasant, that we think are too easy, that don't have the payoff, that we've got better things to do instead of, until the worry curve gets very, very high. So one that I wanted to tell you today is the worry curve for this class is very, very high. Think about it a second. Okay? The last day of class is July 11th. However, July 11th is designated finals day. I don't give a final in this class. However, I do give a lot of assignments. You've already figured that out. That means the last day that assignments are due is the Friday before the 11th, July 8th. Now look at your calendar. How much time do you have between today and July 8th? Hopefully, when you look at your calendar, you realize how little time is left in the semester and how many of these small tasks that may look insignificant, that may look complex, that may look difficult to do, that may look too easy or not have a big enough payoff. They're only 5 points out of 40% of your grade. That you'll start getting worried about those and you'll start finishing and you'll start sending them in. Of course, the standard this semester has been if you finish one of these assignments on time, you are allowed to revise it. Now, I have extended that to several of you, and I'm happy to extend that to more, but please think about this for a second. On July 8th, I only have 3 more days to read your essays. So if you turn in an essay on July 8th, the chances that I will get that read, assessed, returned to you in time for you to revise it for a higher grade are very slim, especially when you consider that not only are you procrastinating, but almost all of your classmates are procrastinating as well, and the chances are I'm going to get an avalanche of submissions on the 8th. So if you want time to revise, you need to get these assignments in as quickly as you can. I'm sorry if I startled any of you, but that was the idea of this particular flash lecture.